laying down in the thing here.
Today's Wednesday, and during COVID, Wednesday is the unpaid gig. It's when I work on my own projects. I'm not heading into the office. Time is way more important to me than money. The money is stuff that I need to get, but time is more important. So anyway, and that's one of the reasons why I'm not starting off with good morning today, because it's 4 p.m. But some of the cutaways that you'll see show you what I was doing today. Last summer, I shot a couple of baking shows, which was kind of experimental stuff, inspired by Jim Gaffigan. Now, Jim Gaffigan would go, "Let's get cooking," and he would repeat that like a dozen times, and Trudy thought those were funny. But they were just literally the stupidest stuff. Like, his cooking show was about boiling water and reheating hot dogs and dumb stuff like that. I had a couple of experimental ideas that I wanted to try. For example, instead of an olive loaf, I did a hamburger casserole loaf. I think that's what you would call it. I don't know. I think we had a name for it, but it was like hamburger and cheese and vegetables, burger helper, except without the macaroni, and baked into a loaf. And it was a whole kerfuffle with yeast supply, and then we ended up with wet yeast instead of dry active, and apparently the ratio doesn't match any of the recipes, and then I got, you know, pizza flour, and it was like something out of a horror movie. It was just expanding at such a horrible rate. That dough was just ridiculous to work with, and we ended up with way too much of it. But it's kind of tasty. It's a lot of work, very ridiculous. I think the video has me cutting away at it to try and get it out of the skillet for like 3 minutes, and that was edited down. So anyway, the moment that I started doing that, and then I started doing the bear thing, I immediately started thinking, what could I do with the bear? Could I get the bear to cook? And when I first bought the bear like 9 years ago at the Calgary Zoo, the reason why we named him Does It is because it was predicated on this sentence. Does a bear know how to drive a stick? Does a bear know how to cook? Does a bear do this? Does a bear do that? It was this kind of concept. And there was going to be all these silly things that you wouldn't think a bear puppet could do. But because the puppet had little mitts that I could put my hands into, there were all sorts of things that the bear could do that a normal bear puppet or bear toy wouldn't do. And that didn't go anywhere. I did the one driving thing, which is the very first video on the Does a Bear channel. And if you're not subscribed to that, like seriously, what's wrong with you? You're missing out on a lot of work, a lot of effort, and if I don't mind saying, some pretty decent comedy. But that's beside the point, because from the moment that I started doing the Cold Bear Report, the Does a Bear show, from the moment I launched the channel, it was like, how do I get it to cook something? How do I do a cooking show with this? What do I do? And I knew it was going to have to be something that was going to be pretty basic, pretty simple. But I didn't want to go the Jim Gaffigan route, boiling water, reheating hot dogs. You know, I didn't want to go that route. I wanted to do something where if somebody actually watched it, then they were going to come away with an idea where it was going to inspire them to do something. Because it was predicated on an experimentation. And what's funny is the experimentation was predicated on a pun. Because we were in the big massive no-frills down at Dixie Value Mall, and they had these tubes of ground lamb from New Zealand, frozen, and the tube was like, if you were to cut patties out of the tube, then you would end up with small hamburgers, and small hamburgers have a name, they're called sliders. So I was thinking, well, okay, lamb burgers, but mini lamb burgers, and then I glommed onto this idea of it being Lamborghini, and Lamborghinis are Italian. So then it was like, well, we got to put mozzarella and tomato sauce on it, and the question was whether that was going to work with a slider bun, a patty of ground lamb, tomato sauce, and mozzarella cheese. Was that even going to work? Would oregano taste good on a lamb? You know, you're used to mint on a lamb. Would oregano taste good on a lamb? So we finally experimented with it. Got the stuff, thawed it out, cooked it up. I can't remember what type of bun we used, but it was bigger bun, so we had to make bigger patties. And it was okay. A little tasty. Trudy really likes lamb. I'm okay with lamb. You know, you're still looking at something expecting hamburger and you get lamb. It's a little bit of a disappointment, but it was nice. It was not bad. It was different. It was tasty. It was like, all right. So then I got thinking, well, how could I get the bear to do this? Does a bear fry up hamburgers? Does a bear make Lamborghinis? Does a bear cook? So that's what today was. I polished off the script. I had to work out the shot list because, you know, the inserts have to be there. And you got to make sure that you get them, so you got to check them off. And then decided what parts of it were going to be two cameras, so I had coverage. What parts of it I was just going to do on the standard front camera, how I was going to shoot that. But then for this vlog, now I got to bring in the crappy third camera because I got to shoot me shooting. Too many cameras. And it was in the kitchen, and how am I going to sit? Where am I going to sit? How am I going to do it? And then what kind of background was there going to be? Was it just going to be the kitchen background, which, you know, when the camera's at the stove looking out, is a really busy, cluttered wall of magnets and stuff? Or is it going to be a black background? If that's what you're going to see cutaway to here. So it's behind the scenes, of behind the scenes, of the scenes that I shot for the cooking segment for the Cold Bear Report.
Does a bear cook? Welcome back, Nation! This week had Mother's Day, and that means we're also coming up on barbecue season! And that means hamburgers! So what you'll need for this is a frying pan. frying pan, or a skillet, or a shallow cast iron. So what you'll need for this is a frying pan. That's a heavy sucker. But also holds up nicely when you have to repeatedly smack sins into certain irritating clods and anti-maskers. Bam, bam, bam. Lean ground lamb. That helps you. It easily portions out the pantry. It easily portions out the patties. Ah! Go back! And as you can see, the size easily portions out the panties. We're cooking panties. Fuck. Easily portions out the patties for cooking the next day. Yay, I did it! The next critical item is small buns. The third ingredient is a white, creamier cheese. For a change, I'm going to use Monterey Jack with jalapeno. Jalapeno? One bare shell, ladies and gentlemen. One bare shell. As you can see, this is an open can, so I'm not going to lift it up because I really don't have a lot of strength. And then using the final ingredient, Italian seasoning. Ugh, see if I can get that. Can you see that? Nope, you can't. Okay, first we want to get the... Okay. This is getting a bit tricky now. A little bit of thyme.
And seriously, if you're not subscribed to the Dozen Bear channel, DUZABEAR on YouTube, I don't know what to do with you. You're missing out on some pretty solid comedy. And of course, I got playlists too. I mean, even if you don't like the political stuff, there's playlists. And then there's Trudy. Trudy's walking through the tulips. Tiptoeing through the tulips. And the other book arrived.
Yay!
Yeah. Yeah, but they shoved it in the box. I almost couldn't get it out.
Oh, really?
You know, because on the Canada Post side of the box, there's more room than there is on the door side of the box. So I'm trying to, it's like, oh, crap. Am I going to damage this pulling it out? But look at the stamps.
Wow.
Your timing is excellent, because I think that's about it. That's all I have to say about this.
Well.
If you're not watching Does a Bear, you're missing out. Bleh. Plus, I'm doing music videos now. Some of those are really cool, because the guy who did the theme for the Does a Bear show, I did two of his songs, and one of them, Johnny Rear-Ender, stars the bear, and it's awesome.
Awesome.
Awesome. You should watch it. Because I think you're only seeing the Does a Bear stuff that's on the Gary Davidson channel. I don't think you're going over to the Does a Bear channel. So you're missing out on hours. And when I say hours, I'm talking about my investment, because it's like 20 hours to do a 15-minute episode. So come on, go over and watch that. And subscribe. And that's it. I'm done. That's what I'm looking up at. Let's see if I can block out the sun without blocking the camera. There we go. Not a bad day. I mean, it's a little windy, but not a bad day. And then there's Trudy. But that's not why you called. Well, maybe. I don't know. Barb seems to like it when Trude does a cameo. Oh, there's a woman with a dog. That's the vlog a day for May the 12th, 2021. I hope you're having a great day wherever you are. See you tomorrow.